In an effort to keep people from going back into the justice system, the New York City Department of Probation is giving its clients what it believes is a better shot at achieving a more productive lifestyle. Here's a snapshot of participants in the South Bronx NeON program.
I didn't think probation would be like this. I don't think probation would help me better myself and better the skills that I need to become successful in life. I just thought probation was just a place that you just come, you just sit down, just wait to see a probation officer, and just have a nice day.
Most people, when they get put on probation, don't want to come to probation. They are just, they're convinced this is a setup, this is, right? So when they show up at a NeON, all of a sudden it's like, wait a minute, this was like 5 minutes from my house. I didn't have to go downtown. This waiting room looks nice. It has sayings, there's magazines, there's resources, there's a TV with public service announcements, and then people are trying to convince me to do things, to join things. So that in and of itself reduces anxiety, get somebody to maybe engage more, and then when they see their probation officers kind of at their same level in many ways, doing things with them, right, and not to them, that adds an engagement component that is critical for anybody to then take stock of where they are and where they need to go to stay out of the system.
Joining us to tell us more about the Neighborhood Opportunity Network, or NeON, is Rodney Levy, Assistant Commissioner for Manhattan Adult Services for the New York City Department of Probation and Associate Director of NeON Photography, Andre Whitehead. Nice to meet both of you.
Hello. Nice to meet you as well.
Honestly, this is, as they say, this is not your mother's probation program. It really is such a, one of those ideas that's such a no-brainer, you sort of think, why didn't it come around faster? So what was the motivation for, you know, changing the, really giving the probation program a real facelift?
Well, former Commissioner Vincent Schiraldi came into office in 2010, and he had a vision, and that vision was actually meeting people where they live and trying to help them, you know, get to where they need to be. And then our current commissioner has continued on with that effort, Ms. Bermudez. And you're right, it's actually the way probation should be. Yeah. We should be trying to help people stay out of jail, meeting them where they are, and providing a good quality service for the community.
But, I mean, you guys, you're even being modest when you say meeting them where they are, because the big thing here is that you meet them where they are, but you really move them where they probably should be going and may otherwise have been going had they not had, you know, some run into trouble with the law and other circumstances in their life. So talk to people, talk to us about exactly what it is that NeON is able to do.
Oh, and the great thing about NeON is, first and foremost, we're in the neighborhood. So clients do not have to come outside of their neighborhoods or get on the train and come down to see us, because that in itself can sometimes be a barrier. So with us being there, we've kind of worked with some community-based organizations. And in Harlem, and I will specifically talk about Harlem because I'm a Manhattan commissioner, Harlem location is inside the Dempsey building, which has 29 other community-based organizations in it.
Okay.
So when clients and citizens come to that building, they don't just see, well, it's a probation office. They see that it's an area or it's a building that can provide services, health, sports, arts, educational, and anything else they need to get them where they need to be.
Yeah, there. I mean, there's so many courses and classes, cooking classes, and I want to bring you into the conversation, Andre.
Yes.
So you were on probation at one time.
Yes.
All right. My understanding is that the loss of one of your friends,
yes,
really made you start thinking about changing your life.
Absolutely. The loss of my friend Chico, his name's Kyle Barnes. Yeah, it definitely was a turning point for me where I realized that that life wasn't for me.
He was shot to death.
He was shot. He was murdered in the park where we grew up. And it was definitely a traumatic experience for me. You know, I didn't know, you know, I didn't know where to go, you know, as far as a way out, but I knew that that life wasn't for me.
And you wanted something.
And I wanted something.
So you were on probation, I understand. It was trespassing charges that you were ended up being charged for burglary.
Yes.
You're going to the probation office. And so what is your first, you know, contact with what they were calling NeON?
Oh, yeah. So a friend of mine, Kirk, he was introduced by our probation officer to the NeON photography program, and which was the first gallery show down in Dumbo, Brooklyn. And he offered me to go there as well. So I went and I met Chelsea Davis, who was my supervisor, and I was introduced to the NeON photography program, and things went good, which is an awesome program. It's a 12-week course. Where it's a free course at that, you know.
Well, you're now the associate director of the NeON photography program.
Sponsored by Seeing for Ourselves.
What was it about that, the photography, that spoke to you and said, that's what I want?
Oh, my first shoot down at Soho, my first shoot, which also was with my friend Kirk Lawrence. We were shooting a birthday shoot and just experiencing a different environment, mm-hmm. being placed in a different environment that I wasn't accustomed to. And just having the assistance of Chelsea there, guiding us through, you know, the framing of photos, the different options on the camera, and just
all of it.
All of that.
It sucked you in.
Yeah, and I knew from that point on that this is what I wanted to do. It was like a rush, you know? It was like a rush, and became my passion.
And when you hear him tell that story, that's exactly what you're hoping for any of the folks that come into the possibilities.
Absolutely. And Andre and I have interacted with each other on a number of occasions.
Absolutely.
And whenever I see him, I talk to him about how well he's done and how well he can do. And that comes from, as he said it so eloquently, exposure.
Mm-hmm.
If we're not exposed to different things in life, then we don't know they're possible.
Mm-hmm.
So it's our job to expose all these young people and older people too, those on probation and those who are not in the community, and then let them know there's another way that they can do things and help them get to their goal.
Now, the NeON program is in all five boroughs, right?
It's in all five boroughs. Mm-hmm. We have seven NeONs, and we have a host of other NeON satellites.
Okay. And reading about NeON, the program is working so well that other cities are considering doing the same thing.
We get visits from other cities, other countries on a regular basis.
And pardon my ignorance about this, but if I find myself in trouble, I'm on probation, can I ask for the NeON program?
Certainly.
How does that work?
Certainly. Mm-hmm. We should be telling you about the NeON program when you first come into probation.
Okay.
We should be letting you know about all the opportunities you have through NeON. NeON photography, NeON sports, NeON arts. We have a nutrition kitchen. We have an animation project. We have so many things to offer, and we want everybody to take advantage of them.
What do you say to people, I'm sorry, and I'll let you speak, to say, you know, that's not being tough on crime. We're about being tough on crime. What do you say to them? Who don't seem to get
it? I say that the Department of Probation will always do what it must to keep the city safe. But at the same time, if we can offer opportunities to people for growth, then we shall do so.
Okay. You wanted to add something?
Yeah. It's not only just for clients that are on probation, you know, it's also for the community.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I have people that are involved in the NeON photography program that have never had any dealings with the law.
Yeah. You know? But if they didn't have something constructive and that they were interested in doing,
the opportunities
for them might find themselves
absolutely.
Mm-hmm. So we want to send folks, the website was nyc.gov/neon, and that will give you more information about this program that really is changing lives and hopefully helping to change the criminal justice system for the better.
We have different exhibits coming up as well.
Tell me about your next
exhibit. The Denise Bibro Gallery.
Mm-hmm.
We have another one with Columbia University. And we have another one in Islip.
And can
Museum.
We find that information on the website?
Absolutely. Soon to come.
To come. Thank you both for being with us this afternoon. It was a pleasure to meet you. I can't wait to see what you do next.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
We'll be right back.